Hey PC World fans, Adam here, and I have a question for you, Elena.
Yes.
I just built a PC at home, and I spent all of my money on a really nice graphics card, and I don't have any money left over for a Windows 10 license. Is there any way I can find one for cheap, or cheaper, or maybe even free?
Actually, yes.
Oh, okay.
There is actually a way to get it for, well, technically free.
Oh, okay, okay. I'm listening.
Yeah. So I would say there's like three different ways you could do it. The first one is probably the easiest one and the one that generates the least controversy in our office, which is to just go out and buy an OEM license.
Okay, I've actually done that before. The problem I have is that it's tied to a single computer.
That's true.
The weird licensing stuff, like why is it so weird like that?
Well, that's what you get in exchange for the discount. So typically a retail license will cost you, like $139 for Windows 10 Home, and then $200 for Windows 10 Pro. That's if like you walked into Best Buy or you went directly to Microsoft and bought it. So OEM license is that in exchange for slightly higher restrictions on what you can do with the software, that you get a bit of a discount. Like, all the features are the same, right? But it's just that you only can install it on that one PC. Whereas the retail version, where you pay more, is that, you know, if you wanted to transfer the license to a new PC down the road, you can do that. And there's no hassle involved with that. Basically, the way that the activation servers recognize your system is that it's like a unique key they generate based on, like, certain components in your system, and the motherboard is one of them. So if your motherboard bites it and you have to replace it, that's why oftentimes the servers won't recognize your PC anymore. But if you were to replace like an SSD or like, you know, your power supply should be okay still, you know, GPU, that kind of thing, then it should be no problem at that point.
So you're pretty much fine until you get a new motherboard then.
Right, and in the past, Microsoft's been fairly lenient about that, where you can, I think you call in and then they kind of allow you to reactivate if you like kind of go through that process, but it's still a hassle. The standard price for OEM license is usually like $110 for home and then $150 for Windows 10 Pro. So, I mean, you're saving between what, like $20 to $50, which is not a huge amount of savings. In exchange for a little bit of a hassle, but it's really hard to get a Windows 10 discount normally.
Yeah, so true.
People, a lot of people just go this route.
Well, do they ever go on sale? Could you get it for even cheaper?
Yes. Sometimes Newegg will actually have a bit of a discount if you watch their daily newsletter. It's not always predictable when they do that, though. So the most predictable time of year to do it would be Black Friday, but you're a little early for that. But if you're willing to wait, you could get it for, I think last year it was $85 for the home version and $120 for the pro version.
Oh, okay, that's not bad. Yeah,
that's not a pretty decent discount at that point.
Okay.
But you have a bit of a wait to go, so maybe one of the other two options might work if that's not enough savings for you. Because I don't know how much money you blew on that GPU.
Also 85, that seems a little steep, you know. So I'm going to listen to the options till I make a decision. So what's number two?
Number two is far more complex, but this is the way that you can get a free quote-unquote version. Quote-unquote because
nothing in life is free.
Right, so here's the thing. This is actually a strategy I can only recommend for U.S. residents. I don't know what it's like in other countries. But basically, you're looking for an education discount. So if you're an adult, then you're no longer, you know, in college, whatever, you can actually sign up for courses at a community college. About half of the colleges I looked at offered some kind of version of Windows 10. So the way it works is that you have to be a student, an active student, or a student current standing, whatever the official term for it is. And the way you can do that is basically by signing up for a one-unit class.
And are there one-unit classes?
Yeah, there are. So most of them are like physical education, so like,
I gotta go back to PE.
Like swim class or a boot camp class or a dance class if you wanted to learn a ballroom dance or something. But there's occasionally stuff like intro to drawing or like intro to HTML, CSS, video production, which
easy.
If you want easy,
I'll take that one easy.
You can do
that.
So you can do it through that, like a one unit class, which in California, which is one of the cheapest states, is like $76 for that class, including the administrative fees. So California offers Windows 10 education, which is kind of like Windows 10 Pro, but better because it's actually closer to the enterprise version of Windows. So you get a bunch of those features and it's a free license. Just as that it's not totally free because you have to pay for the classes. Okay. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. Yeah.
So it'll cost you out of pocket $76, but in the end, what you're getting is the Windows 10 license, and you're also getting that class, which is a pretty good deal if you were thinking about taking classes anyway.
Oh, okay. So it's kind of like an added bonus. Mm-hmm. Are there other bonuses that maybe you can get while you're in there?
I think it depends on the college, but for example, San Francisco City College of San Francisco, there's like free Office 365 account if you're a student.
Okay.
So you get access to, you know, Microsoft Word, Excel, Access, all that stuff, PowerPoint. And then I think Adobe Creative Cloud, the student discount is an option as well. So you're paying like, what, $20 a month for the entirety of the suite, like you access to all of it.
That's great.
So that's an option. It's complicated, which is why this might not be for everybody.
Okay.
You have to go through different steps. You have to sign up for the college, sign up for the class, and then you also have to sign up separately at the vendor and then have them verify your student status usually before you can order the software.
Okay.
And it's not free at every college. I saw some colleges charge like $15 or so, which is still pretty cheap.
Okay.
But it's not free.
So it's a lot of homework just to see up front if this is cheaper than like an OEM.
Yeah. You're right. In order to see if it's an option for you, it does require some legwork.
Okay.
But if you're that broke now, it may be something that you want to spend time. And honestly, I have done the research for you because we both live in California.
Oh, true. Yeah, there
so
you go.
So you're good to go on that front.
My last question on this, do I have to show up to class in order to be...
Okay, so I was that student that loved getting perfect grades when possible,
uh-huh.
So I could never recommend this. And I don't know what every college's policy is about no-shows, because they could drop you from the class eventually.
Uh-huh.
I don't know how that works. But if you're okay with a failing grade on your record, I suppose you don't have to show up for the class.
Do it for the keys, I guess.
Do it for the keys.
Listen, this one seems a little complicated for me. Are you sure there's not maybe another way
there
I can get something
final
for
way.
Real cheap?
There is a final way of doing this, which
comes
with a lot of controversy. I'm just going to present it to you, and you can make your decisions about it as you will. So there is a website called Kinguin.
Kinguin.
And it's basically like eBay or Amazon Marketplace, in that you have a bunch of third-party sellers on this website that sell their, you know, software keys.
Okay.
And among the listings are two for Windows 10, one for the home version and one for the pro version.
Okay.
And they cost, including the, basically it's like buyer protection that you would find on eBay, so the insurance.
Mm-hmm.
With the insurance, it's $33 for a license for home, Windows 10 Home, and $35 for a Windows 10 Pro. And this is an option available to people worldwide.
This seems cheap.
It is very cheap. And the reason why it's so cheap is because I think these are what you would call like gray market type products, which is that they're being sold in a method that was not originally agreed upon between the seller and Microsoft.
Okay.
Which is to say, my guess is that these are probably like leftover keys or extra keys from a volume agreement that somebody had, and now they're just kind of selling them on the side. And that's why they're so cheap. And so that's why there's such strong opinions about going through this route. The people who are in favor of this say, like, it's an amazing deal. As long as you buy the insurance, you're protected against any bad sellers or invalid keys. You know, you don't have to really worry about taking a loss, or, you know, there's no real risk involved.
Okay.
People who are against it say, you know, like, this is not how the keys are meant to be used. So there's that point. Mm. There's the point that because they weren't meant to be used in this way or be sold this way, you could find that your activation status suddenly goes offline at some point. And because these are all OEM licenses that you're buying, then there's the same caveats that we were talking about earlier in the video.
Oh, tied to one machine.
It's tied to one machine. And then if like your motherboard bites it, you have to go through all that hassle. And then there's potentially the extra sticky layer of, because you bought it through somebody else and not directly from an authorized retailer, that kind of stuff. Huge savings, very low hassle, but comes with that big caveat of like, how comfortable are you with all of that?
So you should definitely consider your options and weigh that one heavy before you, yeah. you dive into it.
Just because it can be so controversial. If you've seen any of our other videos, you will know that Gordon is not a big fan of this, whereas Brad is, so.
Okay, well, I'm curious to see what everyone out there thinks, and if you've used any of these options, or if you've never heard any of them, like the education one. I had no idea.
Yeah, I spent a lot of time trying to find ways to save money that
it's smart.
Take a little bit of work.
It's smart. Well, thank you for doing this legwork. I have some thinking to do.
Yep.
And I'll get back to you. Are you sure you don't have like a Windows Vista license sitting around somewhere I can just borrow?
Not even going to dignify that with the response. If you had said Windows 7, I would have been fine. But you said Vista.
I feel like I've seen a lot of Vista keys.
I gotta go.
Sitting around, you know.
I can't be here with you anymore.
Okay. All right. Then we will see you later. Thanks.